Those can move you through space. Please continue to the next area. To your left, you will see a subcritical mass energy pellet. Please use your handheld portal device to direct the energy pellet into the high concentration electron dispersal unit. Excellent. The energy produced by the spelt extractor will be sent to a worthy cause, namely the elevator to the next chamber. Remember, you have approximately 43 hours to complete these tests before the symptoms of dehydration start to kick in. Good luck. Storage cube into the 1500 megawatt hydron magnetic cube stability unit. This will allow you to change the path of the energy pellet. Note that any energy pellet will be destroyed if it comes in contact with the wrong side of a hydron magnetic cube stability unit. You appear to understand the nature of the weighted storage cubes and how they can deflect the energy pellets. Destroying the weighted storage cubes is often required for these tests, and you will not lose points based on how many millions of dollars worth of weighted storage cube technology you destroy. Please do not approach the 1600 megawatt positron energy orb. The positron radiation can cause brain hemorrhages, retinal boiling, internal microwave syndrome, minor lung explosions, and eventually death. If you experience any of the symptoms mentioned previously, then good news, you probably won't need to worry about dehydration.
Do you remember these? Due to all those brain chemicals being pumped into your, brain, you will probably have a difficult time recollecting what makes the green energy pellet special.
The green energy pellets are different in that they have a half-life of 3.25428 million years. In other words, their lifetime is longer than yours by 3.25427 million years, or until you remove pressure from the pump. This chamber will test what you have learned so far. Remember, green energy pellets will last indefinitely without outside intervention. Congratulations. You have proven that you can solve puzzles at third grade level. Please proceed to the exit.
He's telling the truth, you know. This test was designed for children. Most test subjects peak at around 14 years of age, but he was still able to do it after several more years of brain deterioration and joint decay. This isn't a completely normal test run. The point of these tests is to restore power to the powerless sections of the facility. You should keep in mind, however, that you are simply helping me under your massive failure. This test chamber, if completed, will restore power to the Aperture Science Beam Reactor Room. Those poor children, well, probably adults by now, and probably not still alive, are patiently awaiting their automated rubella inoculations.
Congratulations on completing this test. This single energy pellet will power the Aperture Science Pediatric Wing for 5 days. The sick children would thank you if they could speak. Please direct the energy pellet through the Aperture Science radiated flux rectangle. Experience a mild tingling sensation while passing through the radiated flux rectangle. It's probably just your imagination. Or possibly the radiation.
Enjoy the gratification while it lasts. It won't last long.
This test chamber is meant to measure your mind's capacity for object persistence. In other words, this chamber will test your ability to understand that energy pellets exist even when you cannot see them.